with no notice, that the service member can be called away to serve somewhere. And they have to be ready to take over the household duties requirements immediately. Service members for children that don't have a spouse have to make arrangements so that their children are taken care of, again, with no notice. So being a military dependent is one of those things where you never know what's going to happen. It just happens when it does. And having been in an Air Force craft, my dad was in such a deployment, somebody could just get a phone call and be off the missile site in the North Southern Living. Christmas, New Year, and any other holiday. And mom just took care of the house and made the best of it. Actually, she made a great role of taking care of it. So to the dependents, we have both my appreciation and appreciation. That being said, let's start today in prayer. Heavenly Father, we celebrate a day that you've given us. A gift like none other. And for that, we're mighty thankful. Father, we ask your blessing on Pastor Steve's away. Keep him safe. Keep him in the tree. He's up there. And Father, bless this day that he sees you in new ways each and every day. And we also ask a special blessing on his wife as she continues to serve the station. Now, Father, send your Holy Spirit to fill this place, fill us, challenge us, to encourage us, to fill us with joy. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen.
Let's sing this hymn together.
I'm on the chair.
may be seated. Thank you.
keep that family in the fire. The last I heard was Laura had had it, but she was feeling better. It wasn't good, but she was feeling better. A couple others have been diagnosed inside the church with COVID as well in the other church. Father, probably no other time in our year as hard as to come in with heavy concerns on our hearts and prayer and end of the season. Amen. So, Father, we especially lift up now the prayers you've heard, the concerns, the hurt, the fear, and ask you to seek the Holy Spirit. It's that spirit of healing, spirit of recovery, spirit of hope, and restoration. We pray for Zoe especially because this is her first solo. And the sermon message isn't the one she was told. But I did notice that your lap's not big enough. I did notice your lap's not big enough. More kids than she had left. Hey, Tyler.
Papa.
You had a lot liked by your kids. Are you scared? me the entire time I've gotten to know her better and well. She's made me look like a better person. And I can't tell you how special it is to have her up here tonight to share her message. But she's nervous as she can be. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, you gifted us with this very special person. Father, we ask that you send your Holy Spirit to comfort her, to calm her, to guide her, to share the message that you've given to her. Christ, holy name, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. He's right. I'm nervous as can be. I guess that's a fact. The text says if you're not nervous, there's not a message, I suppose. My mom passed away on July 7th this year after a long battle with cancer. It started out as lung cancer. It progressed to liver cancer. And it ended with brain cancer. So what I've got today is sort of a message in regards to her life. And it's all come about in the last 2 years, and then this year with her passing and hearing the song that Rita just sang to you. It came out over a year ago, and I only heard it this year. And then in September, Tack up here with his overalls talked about the days when folks would gather throughout the congregations and the community would come together. Everybody would be here for the day to eat, worship, love on each other, praise Jesus, and have a good time doing all of that. He said people would give their testimony. Well, this is not really my testimony. It's more of a tribute and an honor to my mother. About 2 years after attending here, Joyce Davis was the lay leader at that time. And she was looking for folks to speak on a Sunday morning. And she asked me. And I said, no, thank you. I'm not really good at doing that. Bobby would probably be bad at it. And God has a sense of humor. Because on Saturday night, Bobby gets sick. And on Sunday morning, I'm speaking. The second time that I spoke, this one did. And had asked me. And so the third time was on Wednesday night after supper. I was opening the mic, and I was in the kitchen area, which is not normal for me because I can't cook. But anyway, I was making my way back into here and was going to sit down with Bobby, and my feet didn't stop. And so I had another message apparently. But this message is in regards to my mother. I think I could do better without my mother. I know, but I'm not better than my mother. My mom was born into a large family. There's a picture down here below that gives the majority of the family that she was with on that day. Not everyone was born at that point. She was born in a time in America when the world was coming out of the Depression, except for the poor and common folk. And that's what my mother was. She was poor. She was poor in the fact that money wasn't plenty, but they always had love. You hear that little cliche, but there was love. And there was. And in her strength of learning and living that, she continued to live her life. In an adulthood, she would make clothing for her family. And in learning that everything was valuable and precious, there was no waste. This quilt here is a quilt that my mother stitched, every stitch by hand. These are the fabrics that she used when she made her clothing, not just for her family, but for others. There's not enough money in the world to take it away. Another thing that she did was make sure that her family was fed. This is another tool that she used. It's well seasoned, just like her life was. Lots of things went into the skillet, and lots of love came from it. When she wasn't just cooking for her family, she was cooking for everyone else. If anyone came to the house, there was always something available to eat and drink. And if folks were sick and they couldn't come, she'd pack it all up and take it to them. She loved cooking. One of my special memories when I was a child was when she was in front of the stove and the oven, and it's Christmas time. My brother's favorite Christmas song, the little drummer boy, was on. And then when it went off, Away in the Manger. And at that point, I focused on my mom as she was pulling the cookies out of the oven. Peanut butter, pork rind cookies. They're not really, they don't have those rinds. I taste them today. But she would always make sure everyone was fed. Not just with food, in clothing, but in love. Early 70s, she and my stepdad began to build a house. And the tools that she used there were these. Breaker Hardware. Some of you know the place. She would, and got these because it fit her hand. And she would usually hold it here. And they'd say she's choking the hammer. And she would look at them and she said, "Do you want to be choked instead?" And they would leave her alone. So she built lots of things with this after building a home. And then we moved to town into Dalton. And after that, they were put away for a while. But then there was a need. After the renovations and remodeling, others started needing things, and they knew of her skills. Storage buildings, porches, beds, and lots of wheelchair rooms. Most of it was on her own dime. From a woman who did not make $20,000 a year, she was worth millions to friends who needed it. She used these tools over and over to work in her life and to others' lives. But she had one more tool. The Holy Bible. In this book, there are lots of pages that are bent. There's lots of words that are underlined and highlighted. These are words that came from the prophets. The scriptures that she would read, she would go through time and time again. And many of them are highlighted. They are the words of our Savior, Jesus Christ. She had a lot of tools, but this one is the one that she used the most. And it's the one that I choose. I thank Rita, Jackie, the man, and Sandra for making changes quickly and taking care of that song. To bring my flowers now while I'm living. These flowers are in a term that she used. Make sauerkraut. And these flowers are for you, from me in her honor. Before you leave today, I would love for you to get a flower. If not for yourself, take it to someone else that you love. Look in your toolbox and see what you have. There's a lot in there that we don't even think about. Thank you for your coming. I love you all. I love my mother. And then she's walking.
Mountains by